This week on Lights, Camera, Vegas. I'ma leave the door open. From smooth sounds to a rockin' festival with a nod to nostalgia, we're looking at the latest live music events hitting Vegas. Then,
we're taking things to the next level.
The world of wrestling keeps giving us ringside entertainment, and we're talking to one of the top names about the sport's impact on pop culture.
I want to help.
From Spider-Man to singing, Andrew Garfield's had a superhero year that could end in Oscar gold. And we're catching up with the award show favorite. And dance your cares away as we're heading to Fraggle Rock for an interview that will definitely make you smile. Lights, Camera, Vegas starts right now.
Festival featuring all of your favorites to some newly announced shows, the list of amazing live entertainment in Las Vegas just continues to grow. And we've got your guide to the latest additions. I should be over all the butterflies, but I'm into you. Paramore. My Chemical Romance. And Avril Lavigne are just three of the amazing acts headlining When We Were Young Music Festival, hitting Las Vegas for 2 days of outdoor live music fun. I'ma leave the door open. Be sure to leave the door open for some magical music that's smooth as silk. Bruno Mars and Anderson .Paak, the Grammy-nominated duo Silk Sonic, are ready to heat things up in Vegas with an extended run at the Park MGM.
People who are musical understand the genius of David Foster.
16-time Grammy winner David Foster is bringing his Hitman tour to the Wynn for several additional dates in April. And he'll be joined by a special guest, his wife, singer and Broadway star, Catherine McPhee. Then it's a boy band bonanza as the Pop 2000 tour hits town. Mark McGrath, O-Town, LFO, Ryan Cabrera and Chris Kirkpatrick are all coming together at the Green Valley Ranch Amphitheater. So much good music and good times as we love live music in Las Vegas.
How are you guys?
Oh, we're doing pretty good.
Great. Hi, Rachel.
Oh my gosh, you all look so good. Red, I love your hair.
I do too, isn't it awesome?
Ben, yeah. I'll tell you that.
Gubba, what is life like in Fraggle Rock these days?
Oh, well, it's pretty much the same. You know, lots of hooping and hollering and singing and dancing and lots of diving into the pond. And I'm always exploring and Boober's always doing laundry and Red's laundry. Always swimming. You know, it's a fun place to be.
Rachel, tell me, are you a silly creature or what?
Yes, in more ways than one, I'm a silly creature, yes, from outer space, which I know you guys have only heard of, but, you know, Gobo and Boober and Red, I know Uncle, you know, Traveling Matt goes on adventures. I'm from the outer space place called Las Vegas. Has he ever sent you a postcard from Las Vegas?
No, he hasn't. That's ringing a bell. Is that the place with all those blinky lights? And I feel like there's a lot of dings and dongs. And I don't know, there's lots of cool things there, huh?
Yes, it's a very happy place, like Fraggle Rock. So I'm sure Uncle Matt loved Las Vegas, loved his visit here.
He wasn't making that up? That's a real place in outer space?
It is.
Red doesn't always believe my Uncle Matt goes to the places he goes to, but I know he does.
Doesn't it make you wonder what else is out there? What else is connected?
Hey, okay, it's a party down in Fraggle Rock today.
Yes. Oh, silly creature, Rachel, do you like to sing and dance?
I do. I'm not as good at you as you guys are much more talented, but I like to sing and dance along with you guys, of course.
Oh, wow.
What is your favorite song? What is your go-to song to sing and dance to? What's your number one favorite?
Ooh, there's one that I hear in my head all the time. It's something like
yeah, it makes me want to clap.
Exactly.
It makes me want to dance my cares away, kind of, don't you think?
That's what I was trying to think of.
Wow, you know that song too.
Gosh, that is catchy.
Do you want me to tell any of my fellow silly creatures and silly humans anything from you guys?
Well, just that we're excited to play with them and you know, that we hope that they're having a party like we are, and that, you know, Fraggle Rock's just a really fun place to be.
And you can dance your cares away, right?
Yeah.
She knows our song.
Worry for another day, kids, right?
That's right.
Oh, yeah.
Time to play.
You guys,
Rachel,
thank you so
much. Rachel, it was so nice to talk to you.
Boomer, so nice to talk to all of you. I love your hats. You guys have so much great energy, and have a wonderful day. Tell everybody hi in Fraggle Rock, okay?
Thanks, silly creatures.
Say hi to all the silly creatures.
Down at Fraggle Rock. It's Wednesday night, and you know what that means. A new era, a new season, a new breath for AEW Dynamite.
The world of wrestling just keeps exploding, and president of AEW, Tony Khan, says this is an exciting new era for the sport.
Now, with AEW Dynamite on TBS every week on Wednesdays and Rampage every Friday night on TNT, it's just so huge to have so much great wrestling for the fans every week. You know, it's amazing how fast we've grown, and it's thanks to the great wrestlers and the great wrestling fans.
Absolutely. I mean, wrestling fans are like none other.
Heading to the place where real professional wrestling lives.
It's a new day.
Now is the next chapter.
AEW Dynamite is lighting up the new year with record ratings and more crossover with sports and pop culture.
We've had Mike Tyson has been on AEW many times, and great stars from sports like Shaquille O'Neal. Snoop Dogg has wrestled in AEW. So
Snoop Doggy Dogg, I love it.
What a great guy.
What a great guy.
So it really, really, most of all, try to make the shows fun, but not so much based on sketches and pageantry, but really built around great wrestling matches every week, which is, I think, why fans are so loyal to us.
The new Professional Wrestling League just keeps attracting more fans, proving this ringside show packs quite an entertaining punch.
What a poetic return for Hangman, and we have new champions. What a shocking turn of events.
I mean, I know I look like a trained fighter, of course. The only fighting I did was growing up with my twin sister, you know, fighting her. If you were gonna give me a wrestling name, I'm Rachel Smith, that sounds very boring. What would be my wrestling name and like entrance into the ring?
Raging Rachel Smith.
Woo! I like it.
Raging Rachel.
But then, of course, the song I come out to is Backstreet Boys, so that's not very intimidating.
Dynamite, no doubt about that.
Still ahead, from slinging webs to singing for the first time. Awards are already coming in for Andrew Garfield. He sums it all up coming up. But first, comedian George Wallace is lending his voice to a new comedy.
What kind of password do grown men use?
Try every variation of the word penis, followed by 69.
He's also talking his new Vegas show.
Hey, it's Joey McIntyre, and you are watching Lights, Camera, Vegas with my girl, Rachel Smith.
Well, we're rolling here. Good morning, good evening, good afternoon.
George, how are you? Who is that good-looking fella in green?
Hey, I thought it was blue, but it is green. I got on so many colors. It's so good to see you, Rachel.
Oh, my gosh. George, can I just tell you, you kept me so inspired and entertained during quarantine with all the funny text messages you'd send me. Thank you so much.
But hey, it's just a laugh. You know, you keep laughing your life, you keep living. When you stop laughing, you stop living. So every now and then I will send a little something to make you feel good. That's why they call me Dr. George Wallace.
Because you have the medicine, and the medicine's called laughter.
And you know, laughter is the best medicine in the world. That's why we encourage people to overdose on laughter. Keep it in the reach of children. And when you start laughing for more than 4 hours, then you call your doctor and give the doctor the prescription so the doctor can laugh along with you.
I love that.
Thank you so much.
Everything in moderation except for laughter, right?
Just laugh as much as you can. Sometimes You know, you can't even fake a smile without feeling better. And you smile more than anybody. You just, you know, I look at your beautiful smile right there. See, that makes people feel better. When they see you on TV, they go, there she is.
You've got a pretty good smile yourself. Look at those white teeth.
Listen, between me and you, this must be about $65,000, $75,000 between the two of us. But I enjoy a beautiful smile. And as you can see, you have a great smile.
Oh, honey. Well, listen, you make so many people smile because you have just been entertaining in the most positive, beautiful way for so long. And by the way, you're just giving us more and more entertainment. You got two new shows, one animated and the other one with BJ Novak, right?
Yes, with BJ Novak. It's called The Premise.
Is that a lower back tattoo? What does that say?
Fat.
Fate?
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it's the Fresh Prince font.
My series is called The Ballad of Jesse Wheeler, and I'm the principal of a dying school, decaying school, and I'm about to retire, and these kids are really breaking some rules in, but Jesse is a dropout kid, and he went on to become a great superstar in the music world, and he's coming back to tell all of the kids, if they study hard and get their grades up, he'll do something crazy with them, and the kids go crazy.
You've also got this animated show, which is hilarious.
10-year-old Tom, how about that? 10-year-old Tom, and I'm one of the best. These kids are getting terrible advice from terrible parents, and I'm a lawyer to one. I'm a dad to one of the kids in the show, and I give some bad advice. I shouldn't be doing this. Is a terrible show, but it's funny. Todd Glass and a few others. It is funny.
What kind of password do grown men use?
Try every variation of the word penis, followed by 69.
What's happening? I don't want to cheat, Mr. B.
Tom, you have a moral obligation to cheat.
Come here, you little son of a.
Listen, you have got your new show. I mean, when you're not busy doing all these TV shows and movies, you've got your live show in Las Vegas as well.
This is true. I'm coming back to Las Vegas. I'm coming back right now. I'm working, as you said, but I'm coming back. I'll be at the Flamingo, not the Flamingo. I was at the Flamingo so many years. I'm at the Westgate, and I'm coming back to have some fun. And nothing but jokes. So many jokes. In my life has changed since I last saw you with the being out with COVID. So many things. My grooming, my feet. I got to come to Las Vegas and go get a pedicure. I'm going to go to Home Depot. What do I need? I need a chisel, a saw, hacksaw. I need a jackhammer. My feet are, sandpaper. My feet are jacked up. I don't know, but I'm coming back to Vegas because I love it. So much to do there.
Oh my gosh, so much to do. I mean, when you're not on stage performing, what do you love to do in Vegas? What's your favorite thing?
Eat. I love to go to my favorite restaurant. I might get in trouble for saying this, but Mon Ami Gabi. Oh my God. Have you ever been there? It's the best restaurant. I've been to every restaurant in Las Vegas, but that's my favorite restaurant where I can sit out on the terrace and watch the people that go by, the passersby, and the food is great. The money, the prices are right. All of those great restaurants in Las Vegas, oh my God, I could just go on and on and on. I'll eat cupcakes from a pan and pancakes from a cup. I don't play by the rules. There you go.
I mean, honestly, I have told some of my friends, if you're not following George Wallace on Twitter, why are you even on social media, okay?
So do us a favor, follow me tonight. I want 1,000 people at Mr. George Wallace to join us for some laughs. You need laughter in your life, okay? That's what I do. I got the greatest job in the world, and especially during this time of the pandemic. My job, I'm so blessed that I have a job of creating laughter for people. No matter what the situation is, you gotta come out with a laugh.
They gave us El Pollo Loco. El, you people from back East Detroit, y'all don't know what I'm talking about, do you? We got a Mexican chicken out here on the West Coast called El Pollo Loco. Y'all better get you some of that chicken before you leave. That chicken is so good, another chicken will eat that chicken.
You see, I don't curse now, but on stage, I met a rapper in Atlanta, and his name is Waka Flocka Flame. So as you know, I use Waka Flocka when I want to cuss, you know? And everybody out there, I want to thank all you Waka Flockas for listening today. So that's my curse word. I'm going to get grounded. I know that.
Waka Flocka.
Waka Flocka.
I know. I call 50 Cent Half Buck. I go, can I call you Half Buck? Half Buck sounds better, don't you think?
You are crazy. 50 Cent, oh my God. That's another shot. I have more shots than 56 Fifth Shot.
I need you to put that at 50 Cent.
That's amazing. I'm twisted, tongue twisted now because we just wrote a joke and I got to remember that joke about 56. I've had more shots than 50 Cent. Bam, Rachel wrote a joke.
Do I get a co-write credit?
Why, you walk a flock of you. No. Written by my good friend, Rachel Smith. You should go on stage. You should be a comedian.
Ed McMahon to your Johnny.
Why don't you come on stage with me one night and do 5 minutes? Oh, I know you could do that.
I would do anything, but I don't be like, I would just laugh at your jokes and then throw them back to you.
That'd be great, yeah. So maybe we should get a TV show together.
I would do that.
Hey, Rachel, you already have a TV show.
Life is a lot like ice cream. It starts out sweet, and then you die.
Wow.
That's why I love Las Vegas. Vegas has it all. Now, you heard me say that. That's going to be the new city slogan. Vegas has it all.
And George Wallace.
I'm Dr. George Wallace. I love you. There's absolutely nothing you can do about it. And Rachel, my love for you does not require your permission.
But you got it anyway.
You got it anyways, yes.
Still ahead, how nervous was Andrew Garfield to sing in front of the camera for the first time?
You're offering up, you know, part of your heart.
But first, we're looking at some hidden gems worth discovering in Las Vegas in this week's Vegas Hot List. The Vegas Hot List, brought to you by Pepper.
Step inside the 6,000 square foot playground of Pepper. Don't know where to start? No worries, this is much more than a store. Pepper is an all-around luxury sexual wellness experience which even provides a staff of connection concierge. Their goal is to help guide you in the pursuit of pleasure by making you feel comfortable in an environment aimed at celebrating intimacy free from shame. From a better connection with your partner to self-care, Pepper is truly passionate about improving this very important part of our lives. And we're passionate about this week's hot list, looking at some hidden gems worth discovering here in Las Vegas. He's the man who inspired the movie Ford versus Ferrari. And you can get a look into the heart and mind of Carroll Shelby at the Shelby American Heritage Center. The free daily tours give you a great look at the history of the American automotive experience. And the incredible cars on display are priceless and really fun to see in person. Did you know you can see mermaids in the desert? Well, you can at the Silverton Casino, where their tropical aquarium has thousands of fish, along with sharks, stingrays, and real-life mermaids. Located off the Strip, it's been voted one of the best free attractions in Las Vegas. Travel back in time to the Prohibition era with a trip to the underground. This 1920s-inspired speakeasy can be found in the basement of the Mob Museum. And along with historical artifacts, you'll enjoy Prohibition craft cocktails and live jazz, but be sure and use the password of the week to get in.
The longer you do it, the more dangerous it becomes. I want to help.
Andrew Garfield's making headlines for two top films this year. Of course, with his return to Spider-Man in No Way Home, which has now become the biggest blockbuster of all time.
What does it take to wake up a generation?
It would be a tragedy to give up what you have.
But it's his performance in Tick, Tick, Boom that's earning him Oscar buzz. In fact, he just won the Golden Globe for Best Actor, and landing this role was a golden opportunity for the star to sing for the first time.
Andrew, I'm out of Las Vegas.
All right, let's go, Las Vegas.
Woohoo! Have you been recently?
No, not in so long. I'm in and out. I'm like a one night in, I lose $50 at the blackjack table and I get the hell out.
Big spender.
Big spender. Frugal.
By the way, congratulations, first of all, on this beautiful film. And I mean, just what a gift. It really is.
Thank you so much. I feel very, very grateful to have been a part of it and to be able to bring it to people. It's a beautiful feeling.
Except for the fact that, hello, you have been holding out on us. I mean, I think when the world hears your voice, they're going to be offering you, I mean, move over, Celine or Bruno. They're going to be offering Andrew his own Vegas residency.
Yeah, I think it's time. I think it's time for the Andrew Garfield Vegas residency. I don't know what I would sing or perform, but we'd figure it out.
Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer.
You know, I learned to sing for this. I got to a chance to work with great coaches and had all the time to get my voice to the place where I could feel like I could start to honor John Larson. So I just feel so grateful.
Well, I have to imagine it's equal parts exciting and frightening to put yourself out there like that. And I love how there's this beautiful scene with the brilliant Judith Light, who plays your publicist. And she's talking to Jonathan about the vulnerability of presenting his musical. And I'm sure you could really relate to that because it's the first time you put yourself out there singing on film. Was it something that you could really in that moment relate to?
Oh, definitely, of course. But I think that's a feeling that you have with any creative work. Like, yeah. You know, for instance, we released our movie. We had our premiere a couple of nights ago, and it was just absolutely terrifying because you're offering up, you know, part of your heart, a big part of your very vulnerable, bleeding heart to an audience, and they're either going to respond to it or not. And so there's something very moving about that. There's something just deeply, yeah, as you say, vulnerable and but life enhancing and enlivening about that as well.
This is the start of many other singing roles for you because you've got it, my friend.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Thank you.
And we'll see you in Vegas for the show.
Yeah, I'll see you in 2025 when I figure out what I'm going to do.
Okay, sounds good. And you can see Andrew Garfield in Tick, Tick, Boom now as it's streaming on Netflix. Then expect to see him on every red carpet throughout award show season as his performance is up for nearly every award possible, and rightfully so. It is so good. Guys, thanks so much for being with us for Lights, Camera, Vegas. Until next time, take care.